Alden Belenfante with us. Mr. Belenfante, good morning.
Good morning. And see you. Good morning, all.
We'll be talking a little bit more with you about the school. This is a relatively new school.
Yes, it's just celebrated its 10th anniversary, opened in 2004. One of the first opening in Northwestern school building program.
Right, and I notice you have a special design here. I mean, the facility is so beautiful, just walking in to see a school that's so well built and well kept.
Well, they're all, in fact, if you visit the other 17 schools, you realize that they're all of the same design. Yes, but beautiful, beautiful, very aesthetically built and very conducive to students learning.
All right, in a little bit, we'll be talking a little bit more about the institution itself and its achievements, which I know you can't wait to talk about.
Now, each student is going to read what their letter stands for, beginning with my friend to the first, to the extreme right. Go ahead, please.
K. K is for kind. No act of kindness, no matter how small, is ever wasted. I. I is for integrity. Integrity is the kindest principle.
N. N is for nice. Be nice to everyone.
D. D is for random. Do random acts of kindness every chance you get.
N. N is for nurture. Nurture your friends and relationships.
E. E is for everyone is beautiful.
S. S is for see. See the good in everyone.
S. Send a card or a handwritten note saying thank you to your teacher.
All right, wonderful. Now that's the acronym KINDNESS. You have to listen up because this is where it gets sweet. So we have one, two, and we have, all right, we have four persons. We're gonna do this quickly. Listen up, everyone. All right, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to be asking, what's your name?
Nova Wilson.
Nova, what's your name?
Shaidi Golden.
Daniel Mason.
All right, so Daniel, Shaidi, and Nova, we're going to be asking you one at a time, beginning with Nova. You, your job, you are going to show us how many acts of kindness you can do in 60 seconds. So let me give you an example. Let me give you an example. An act of kindness, you can hug somebody. An act of kindness, you can help somebody with something quickly, but you have to do it in 60.
Tell somebody they're beautiful.
Yeah, right. Tell me I'm beautiful.
All right.
Right? Tell some. So you, we're going to send you out into that crowd right there, and you are going to do as many acts of kindness as you can in 60 seconds. So you're going to keep the bag on your back. And of course, your 60 seconds, you have to go down.
All
we're
right.
Waiting on you to get down.
So we're ready now to count down.
Your 60 seconds begin right now.
Okay, there you go.
And look at her as she runs. She's running through the crowd.
Two.
And her bag is on her back.
Three.
And of course.
Four. Five. Six. Seven. Now she's
eight.
Going through the crowd. She's hugging some people. Now.
That's eight. That didn't count. Oh, nine.
She straightened someone's uniform.
Ten.
Fixed up someone's hair.
11.
All right. Someone looked as if they were struggling holding their bag. She took it and
12.
Just,
Hold on. We have to question that one, you know.
We're 13, going through.
14. 15.
Help us count from the back. 16. 17.
The crowd. That's
17. 18. Oh,
17.
I think she just told the camera.
Miss up, we have 18.
18.
So, come back now,
in
mother.
1 minute.
All right. Now, so Nova, you did 18. Let's see if Shahidi can beat you. It's your turn, Shahidi. It is now Shahidi's turn, and your 60 seconds begins now. And you, listeners, oh, two. Three. Four. Five. Six. And listeners, we wish you could see this. She's going through, she's straightening uniforms. She's giving money. That's about eight right there. Nine, she's brushing someone's hair. We have nine so far. 30 seconds to go. She's cleaning someone's shoe. 10. 11. And we're now at 40 seconds with just 20 to go.
Keep going, keep going.
And we're at 12. Shahidi. 13. 52 seconds. 13. 14. And of course, your time is up.
Whoa, so who's in the lead?
Yeah,
I am Nova.
What? Are you ready? And we go in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, Daniel is up. One, okay.
Two,
three, four, five. Whoa.
Six.
Oh, wow. She's fixing the bags on. Yeah. Oh, man.
Seven. Wow. She's going fast.
I think he showed someone
nine,
that, hey,
ten,
your shoelace.
11.
Your shoelaces 12, are undone.
Wow. 13. She's on fire. 14.
Oh, my. She's
15,
going. Nova, you're in trouble. Are you 16, worried, Nova?
17. Woo.
You are worried. At 18, 31 seconds. At 32 seconds, she beat Nova's number.
That's 19 right
And she's
there.
Going. 19.
That's 20 right there.
20.
21. 22. 23. 24.
Whoa.
25.
And she's just moving right along.
27. 28.
And
your time is up.
Ah, time is up. 29.
Wow, 29 acts of kindness in 60 seconds. So, Daniel.
Hi, I'm Daniel Black, the president of the Inter-School Christian Fellowship Club at Irwin High. I wholeheartedly agree that kindness in schools matters. I support NCUFM and TV's Acts of Kindness, High School Tour, and Kindness Campaign. You know, as Cleveland Army said, what this world needs is a new world, is a new army, an army of kindness. ISCF Clubites everywhere, let's serve with kindness.
All right, now talk to us about some of the proudest achievements. I know there are many, but some of the achievements of the school that you want to share with Jamaica.
Well, basically, as I said, Irwin High School started in 2004. We started very small with only 456 students. And we started with only grade 7s and grade 9, a cohort of GNAT and a cohort of GSAT students. Since that time, we have managed to expand when we have a full cohort of 7, cohort of 7 to 11. We now have added grade 12 and 13 over the last 3 years. Still very small, but we are building on that. The school, to some extent, has increased, has improved in terms of its academic standard. As I said, our first set of students, only GSAT, only graduated in 2009. So those students would only have graduated from college 2 years ago. So we still don't have an effective and efficient and impactful past student association, because they are just getting them their act together. We have some very innovative programs throughout the school that I'm going to tell you many other schools want to emulate, want to. And we, in fact, I just wrote a paper this morning which says, whenever our teachers go to training elsewhere in Jamaica, they are told, Irwin High, we hear about it all the time. We want to come and visit you. And when teachers say they don't want to leave either. Mm-hmm. And they leave and take some of the things. We have what is called, you notice I said the students who came across were from Nettleford. We have what is called a management system, which is vertical tutoring. Mm-hmm. So we don't manage our students on a horizontal basis.
What's that all about for those listening?
All right, for horizontal tutoring, most schools do on a grade level. You manage along grade level, grade 7, grade 8, grade 9. We manage on a house system where your vertical management, where each house each house as a house master who really is an assistant principal.
Okay.
Because they have one grade 7, mm-hmm. one grade 8, one set of grade 9, one set of grade 10, a set of grade 11. To that extent, they have an entire school.
Okay.
And so therefore, they themselves are really an assistant principal to manage. Within each house are 8 tutors. Each tutor then divide up with 5 grade 7s, 5 grade 8s, 5 grade 9, and it helps because it helps to develop leadership, it helps to develop mentorship. So the grade 7s at any time at all, when they are in their tutorial groups in the mornings and it's being discussed with grade 9, what's your option choice for grade 10? They know before they reach grade 9.
Wonderful.
Having set that pastoral base, that management system where we concentrate a lot on values and attitudes, it moves now that we are very well taking our students to the next level in terms of academics.
Principal
and you're
Belafonte,
seeing the results.
Thank you so very
thank
much.
Thank you so much. Mr. Belafonte, give him a hand.
To be lost in the middle of an ocean, I have no place to lay your head. To be caught in the web of indifference, cast aside like you're just as dead. To be forgotten like the wind of yesterday, neglected and beaten and worn. The pain that you're feeling is just as real as the ground you're standing on. Well, it's not over now. This is not the end. You've been tossed and beaten up. You fall again. I know your heart's being torn, and you say there's no point in carrying on. The race is not over. It's not over now.
Hi, we are the leaders of the Thompson Society of Irwin High School. Does kindness matter in schools? You bet it does. And it starts with us. We support service to others on this campus. Thank you, NTU-FM and NTU-TV, for taking acts of kindness high school to Irwin High. We will continue to serve kindly.
Mr. Reed, rather. Miss Low Walters. And the winner by a landslide, Mr. K. Smith.
All right. So we invite these three teachers.
Mr.
To come
Smith,
forward.
Where are you? Come on up.
So clap them as they come. Clap them, clap them, woo! Clap them, clap them.
And judging from the applause. Judging from the applause. We're all in favor. Now, hold on. Don't I know, aren't you an NCU past student?
Yes, sir.
Now, it says a lot.
Yes.
Congratulations, Mr. Smith. And we have your special prize for you.
Presented
now,
by our marketing
presented
manager.
By our marketing manager, our sales and marketing manager, Mrs. Keisha Ann Thomas.
A landslide. Very impressive. Congratulations from NCUFM. And this gift is courtesy of iCool, iCool for Life. And you have a branded mug from NCUFM, your education and wellness station.
Boy, you see how it go? He has drinks from iCool, iCool for Life. And he has a mug from NCUFM. So, you see, you have what it takes to deal with that. Congratulations again, Mr. Smith. A big round of applause. The other two teachers, the runners-up, Come on up. We have prizes for you too. And Miss Lou Walters. Man, yay! Yes,
and of course,
wonderful. And so the presentations will be made. And so.
Hi, I'm Kenny Smith, winner of the NCUFM Acts of Kindness Teacher Award from Irwin High School, voted by the students. You're watching NCU TV, bringing education and wellness to life.
The student was selected by your teachers here at Irwin High. And so it's time for the grand announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Keisha Ann Thomas. And we're going to invite, the principal to make this announcement. The student was chosen by the teachers, and I'm sure you have something else you want to say about our recipient. Right. Now, tell us about the student and why she was chosen, first of all, before we mention the name.
All right. Can I say, all the teachers were involved with this. In fact, housemasters. The housemasters who went around, spoke to all, they looked at the reports, especially the last report, and decided who would be the best student. And this student has been extremely helpful around the school. Sometimes I'm not going to try and take away anything from the housemasters, because most times I don't see a student unless they walk into my office. But this one is quite visible and truly represent the prize or the award that they are getting now. I must make one comment about it. She is here today as having been in that terrible accident yesterday, and we want you to recognize her with a loud round of applause.
And the name is
Vanessa Smith. You don't know her. Vanessa Smith.
Vanessa Smith. Give her a big round of applause. Congratulations, Vanessa Smith. And Vanessa, she has a little difficulty in, walking. Well, yes, she, with the help of our friends, she is here with us now. But Vanessa, we are going to be presenting to you this plaque. And this is for being consistent in showing kindness and being a good example for your fellow students here at Irwin High. So the presentation, first of all, of the plaque.
Vanessa, we just want to congratulate you. It is a beautiful thing that you have been chosen as the winner of this award, the Acts of Kindness High School Tour Kindness Award, being presented to you today by NCUFM, your education and wellness station. We want to congratulate you and encourage you to keep it up. You also have won to yourself a gift voucher valid at $6,000 from Brian's Bookstore. Congratulations from NCUFM.
Right, and this is compliments of the Caroline Hart Foundation. Congratulations to you, and may you always continue to show acts of kindness. And you see, when you show acts of kindness, it comes right back to you. I couldn't help but notice how eager your friends were to help you to get to where you are right now. A beautiful day it is. And we want to thank you so much. And we're also going to be presenting to the housemaster and principal a little kit. And it's all about a DORAK club. Do Random Acts of Kindness. DORAK. DORAK club. Yes? And we want to see you starting your own DORAK club here at the Irwin High School. Now, housemaster? Housemistress?
Okay, before we say thanks, I just want to say something more on Vanessa. I teach her also language and literature. Very, very hard worker, very, very caring. Even for her great supervisor who is now pregnant, she's always helping, willing to help her, offer her assistance to her every day, every day. And of course, she was involved in an accident yesterday. She was one of the nine. And of course, we are proud as Lekkiites for this achievement. Lekkiites! Hey!
Oh boy, the house spirit is really alive here. And we have a response. And this will be read by one of her friends. This Shanique is going to be reading this on behalf of Vanetta as we get ready to close our broadcast for today.
I am guided by the verse from Proverbs 3, verse 3. Do not let kindness and truth leave you. Bind them around your neck. I believe that God smiles on kindness, thus I want him to smile on me. I remember when Kiana's mom died, and I helped her smile, and this made me feel good. When we are kind to others, it makes them happy. When those around us are happy, our world becomes a brighter, lighter place to live. It is humbly to think that I have so much to give thanks. In a difficult world, kindness has an amazing power. Each and every one of us can change the world by being kind.
Thank you so much. Another big round of applause for Vanetta Smith.
It's the 2016 Acts of Kindness High School Tour from NCUFM 91.1, 91.3, and 91.5. Today we are in Irwin, St. James, and I'm sitting with the recipient of the Acts of Kindness Award for Irwin High, Vanetta Smith. Hi, Vanetta, how are you doing?
I'm okay.
How do you feel? How did you feel when you found out that you were the one selected for this award?
Excited.
Share with us why you believe your friends, your colleagues, and your teachers decided that you were the one to receive the award.
I always try to help them anytime they're down. I always try to make them smile. My teacher, she's pregnant, so I know she can do a lot. So I try my best to help her, take her stuff to her car and all of those stuff, help her move to classes and things.
From where would you say you developed this culture of kindness? Where did that come from in you?
You don't know. Just like to help.
From your mom, from church, from?
The family and church.
That's how it is in your family?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We understand you were in a bad accident yesterday, but yet you showed up to school today.
I have to thank God that it could be worse.
Mm-hmm. What would you have to say to other young people your age about being a kindness activist? Yes, you know, to be always the one to demonstrate what it means to be truly kind.
Them a better person.
It will make them a better person. Indeed, it will make you a better person as you continue to help make this world a better place, one kind act at a time. Vanetta Smith from Irwin High School, thank you so much. I know it's a little emotional and, you know, it's a lot to handle. You know, while you're thanking God for sparing your life and also to be recognized by your teachers as one who demonstrates what it means to be kind. But again, congratulations to you and keep on carrying out those acts of kindness.
Thank you.